miss my home. You know, I was here for so many months that it got to a point I got used to being home, and I like it. So I was very happy. Remember, I always tell you that Ihaliakala used to tell me, you know, home has nothing to do with the physical, you know, outside of yourself. It's always home is here. So that means if you are always home. Yes, no matter where you are always home. And if you are okay with your home, then you are okay wherever you are in the world. So that happens to me, and I learned that as I started traveling so much and being away from home so much. I started kind of experiencing that. You know, sometimes it's hard to leave home. Yes, my house, but as soon as I close the door, as soon as, well, you know when it really, it's the liberating part is when I check in, you know, and they take my luggage that is usually heavy, and you know and I see my suitcases go, you know, and then I feel, oh, I feel relief, and then I'm present, you know, moment by moment, and enjoying wherever I am and the different experiences. Well, the spiritual trip to Chichen Itza was something else, really. It was something beautiful. It was really experiencing 5D, you know, being on the fifth dimension, you know, realizing that you were in completely in a different world. I think I shared it with you in my last life, but I just wanted to be sure that I could share with you a little bit more about what the experience is. If suddenly you are even invisible, and the things that we got to do that were really out of this world, some of them we cannot even share publicly, you know, because it was really out of this world. And we don't want to get anybody in trouble because of allowing us to do what we did, being at places at the time that we were, and et cetera, et cetera. But anyway, we were kind of invisible, and the things that we were able to create. So last weekend was in Guadalajara, and being able to have almost 200 people there in the room was also very, very, very special. We realized still there are a lot of people, you know, engaging with the fear, and maybe some even canceling last minute. But now more than ever, you know, we have to concentrate on being in our center, on trusting. You know, we need to trust, trust, trust. We've been preparing ourselves for this moment, and we need to know that we are guided, that we are protected, that there is nothing we need to worry. You know, that we have the roots, you know, strong enough that things are going to happen, but we are going to stay in our center, that we know better. Yes, but right now, faith is the most important, and gratitude. Talking about gratitude, happy Thanksgiving to you today. The reason I have decided just to kind of show up is because, well, tomorrow I'm doing a mini workshop. I hope mini Ho'oponopono workshop for Russian people. Yes, we are gonna do it in English with translation to Russian. It's the training that I had done. You know, I have done it in English, in Spanish, some month ago. By the way, it is we have it on the store if you would like to have access to it. But tomorrow I'm doing it with translation to Russian, so that will be a great opportunity to clean, as always. And then Saturday I'm doing a virtual in Spanish for the people that were registered for the Madrid trip training, because this weekend I was supposed to be in Madrid in Spain. So I'm doing some Ho'oponopono virtual training as an advance for the people that were already registered. Yes, and then definitely we know in our hearts that one day we are gonna do, I'm gonna come to Madrid, and we are gonna have the training there. So This is just an advance, yes? And also the importance of getting together and cleaning right now, how important, you know, and to be reminded and reconnect with ourselves and et cetera, et cetera. So that's why I thought, you know, Thanksgiving is a great day to be here with you, to connect, to say thank you. Thank you for showing up in my life. Thank you for giving me all these opportunities to clean. And I wanted to, well, first let's do I Am the I to start, yes? So remember, I Am the I is very good to open, it's very good to come from pure of heart. And that doesn't mean we are not going to have problems, yes? But you know, you never know what you avoided or what could have happened. And you always have to say thank you. Actually, in the live that I just did in Spanish, I share a testimony from this grandma that tells me that she instructed her oldest grandson, you know, with Ho'oponopono, and taught him about it and gave him some tools and things like that. And the boy was in an accident with part of the family, and actually, well, the track that they were going on, you know, it was completely destroyed, but nobody was hurt. And the boy told the grandma, you know, grandma, in that moment, I remember what you told me. And I started repeating, gold ring, gold ring, gold ring. And then another boy that was there, he says, oh, I wish I had a time machine, you know, that I could see the future. So that way I wouldn't have gone in the... on that trip. And the boy says, are you kidding me? You know, I needed to be there because I had to clean. Otherwise, I don't know what could have happened if I wasn't there. Yes. So can you imagine an 80-year-old boy, you know, that can see how this works, that can trust, that can remember to use the tools, you know, because it knows it works, and that trust in our heart. So important. Right now we have to be courageous. Right now we have to trust uncertainty, you know, and knowing again in our hearts that we are protected and guided. Okay, so I am the eye. I come forth from the void into light. I am the breath that nurtures life. I am that emptiness, that hollowness beyond all consciousness. The eye, the ear, the all. I draw my bow of rainbows across the waters, the continuum of minds with matters. I am the incoming and outgoing of breath, the invisible and touchable breath, the undefinable atom of creation. I am the I. Okay, so I have Thanksgiving proclamation. I don't know if you know this story from Abraham Lincoln. We have been the recipients. Okay, in 1863, in the midst of the Civil War, Abraham Lincoln established the annual celebration of Thanksgiving. We have been the recipients of the choicest bounties of heaven. We have been preserved these many years, in peace and prosperity. We had grown in numbers, wealth, and power as no other nation has ever grown. But we have forgotten God. We have forgotten the gracious hand which preserved us in peace and multiplied and enriched and strengthened us. And we have vainly imagined in the deceitfulness of our hearts that all these blessings were produced by some superior wisdom and virtue of our own. Intoxicated with unbroken success, we have become too self-sufficient to feel the necessity of redeeming and preserving grace, too proud to pray to the God that made us. It has seemed to me fit and proper that the gift of God should be solemnly, reverently, and gratefully acknowledged with one heart and one voice by the whole American people. I do therefore invite my fellow citizens to set apart and observe the last Thursday of November next as a day of thanksgiving and praise to our beneficent Father who dwell in the heavens. So, you know, today's celebration has all, it's all related to thank God. Thank God for what we have. Thank God for who we are. Thank God for the opportunity to be here in such important moments of history, you know, here on the planet. Thank God that is giving us the opportunity, that trusted us, you know, to be here, to help, because there is something that we can do that nobody else can do. So, so important that we realize this. So important that we that we really thank God for everything. We don't realize how lucky we are, you know, that we have. We posted a video today. I hope you watch it, you know, of this story of this blind boy. Yeah, sometimes we don't realize how lucky we are that we can see, that we can walk, you know, that we have two arms, that you know how expensive human organs are, you know how wealthy you are for every organ, human organ that you possess, you know, again, that you can see, that you can walk. Sometimes, you know, we don't stop to really realize about all these gifts. Okay, so I invite you to do the breathing ha. Yes, that's a way of bringing mana or divine energy that transmutes. Remember, we all have to work. The most important is that we work on our subconscious mind, where all these memories are, that we set ourselves free, that we let go of the past, because this is the time to let go of the past, to be able to be able to ascend, to be able to take advantage of this opportunity that God is giving us of living in the fifth dimension. Yes, to ascend, to be able to connect with our with our real families out there. Yes, and to realize who we are and recover all our powers. Yes, because we are all very powerful, but we forgot. Yes, and we are always, you know, engaging with the thinking, with the reasoning, instead of really coming more from our hearts. So right now it is time to come from our hearts. Right now it's time for us to reconnect. And again, you know, to be centered. Yeah, because our vibration is what is going to save us. You know, if we raise our vibration, there is nothing we need to worry about. We just need to reconnect. And Ho'oponopono brings us to neutral. And be grateful, put you in positive, and acceptance, you know, that everything is perfect, yes, even if it doesn't look like. Your willingness to clean, your willingness to let go, your willingness to take 100% responsibility. Okay, so breathing ha, remember we put the three fingers together, and then we interlock, yeah, we form the infinity sign. So three fingers together, and then we open, we interlock it, we put it on our legs, we put our spine, you know, erect, your feet on the floor. I'm gonna guide you, I'm gonna ask you to close your eyes, I'm gonna guide you, and then I will ask you to do it. So remember, when we do this, we don't think about the problem, we don't repeat anything, we just breathe and count. We breathe, we inhale and exhale through the nose, and we only count. So I'm gonna inhale and count seven. So inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then I'm gonna hold my breath for 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then I'm gonna exhale through the nose for 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then I'm going to hold my breath again for 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And that's one round or one time, and we do that 7 times. So close your eyes, just do the 7 times, and when you are done, open your eyes. Thank you. Thank you. I would like to share with you something that I wrote, I don't know how long ago, but it says the power of thank you and zero frequency. So we remind ourselves, yes, of the power of thank you. Every time you say thank you, instead of engaging, you stop your thoughts, your beliefs, the opinions and judgments, everything that is not you, and you go back to zero. Once I was teaching in Romania, a student came up to me during a break and said, I know it cannot be this easy. How can choosing to say thank you all the time change my life? He told me he had been on his spiritual path for a long time and that his teacher, a person he trusted very much, had conditioned him to believe spiritual work was difficult. A week after the training, I received an email from him. At home or at work, I daily read some of the thoughts of Omram, my source of wisdom. I trust his words 100%. It helps me get back on track and stay motivated. I just opened one of his books and read a few pages. So after the Ho'oponopono training with you, I took one of Omram's books, opened it up, and started reading. And here is what I read. I gave you, in my lectures, tons of methods for spiritual evolution. I gave you so many methods that in a lifetime you cannot even try all of them. But if you want to stick to only one method for own limiting beliefs, but if you want to stick to only one method for spiritual evolution, then use this one. Just say thank you to the divine. Thank him all the time. And this will be enough. So he was shocked, yes, when he read that. He says, I immediately had a reaction and said to myself, wow, how did he know? How could this be? He's a Bulgarian. He has nothing to do with Hawaii. This is not possible. And then realize my own limiting beliefs were controlling that thought. So I simply say thank you. Within seconds, the words wash away all those limiting beliefs. Yes, because we are always, you know, engaging with our beliefs, yes? So many times we are stuck in our ideas and make bad choices based on our limiting beliefs. For example, many of us believe life is hard, so we suffer. The question is, will you choose to be right or be happy? If happiness is what you really want to choose, then you must say thank you for everything, everywhere, at every moment. Many scientific studies support the power of thank you. Dr. Masaru Emoto, author of The Message from Water and The Hidden Messages in Water, was introduced to the concept of microcluster water in the United States. And using magnetic resonance analysis technology, discovered that it is in its frozen crystal form, water shows its true nature. In these studies, Dr. Emoto researched the power of thought on water, and what happens when we say thank you or I love you to it. As witnessed in the groundbreaking movie, What the Bleep Do We Know?, the results were amazing. Dr. Emoto proved beyond the shadow of the doubt our thoughts have an incredible impact on the molecular structure of water merely by thinking, thank you or I love you. Just remember, we are mostly water. What we do to ourselves with our thoughts, when we don't believe in ourselves, when we don't love ourselves. We discussed the law of attraction in my introduction, but there are many other universal laws we need to respect, remember, and work with. The law of gratitude is one of the most powerful, and it is confirmed by the by the further scientific research undertaken by Dr. Robert Emmons at the UC Davis Emmons Lab. Calling gratitude the forgotten factor in happiness research, Dr. Emmons, author of the books Words of Gratitude, The Psychology of Gratitude, and Thanks, is currently heading a long-term research project designed to create and disseminate a large body of novel scientific data on the nature of gratitude, its causes, and its potential consequences for human health and well-being. Can you imagine, you know, that thank you is so powerful? Remember what Ihaliakala said, you know, if you could see what happens when you say thank you, you wouldn't stop saying thank you. In a similar vein, Deepak Chopra discusses the law of least effort in his New York Times bestseller, The Seven Spiritual Laws of Success. Saying thank you, you takes very little effort, along with the law of detachment, no resistance, accepting things exactly as they are, with no opinions or judgments, knowing that everything is always perfect. The subtitle of Dr. Chopra's book is A Practical Guide to the Fulfillment of Your Dreams. Letting go and saying thank you and I love you is one of the most powerful practical declarations of your freedom and release you could possibly make. At zero frequencies where your dreams are fulfilled. Please know this, that everything in your life is temporary and will one day pass, so thank you. Remember, pain is inevitable, but suffering is optional. The more challenges we have, the more blessings come our way. So thank you every time one door closes, because it gives permission for another, better, bigger door to open. Say thank you and tune in to the right frequency, the zero frequency, so you can start attracting what is right and perfect for you effortlessly. Okay? So please trust. The thank you is an incredible tool. Remember, in Ho'oponopono, you don't actually need to feel it. It's not like you are saying it to anybody outside yourself. It's just a passcode. But make that list also of the things you can be grateful for, and you'll see how your life could change for the better. Okay? So please trust, trust, trust. And now I have my, I will have to go because I have my monthly class. Remember, in the memberships that I offer, we have a class that, a monthly class where I answer all your questions. You can talk to me directly if you want. Now we are using Zoom, actually, for the monthly classes. And you can enjoy a month of all the benefits of membership, like the inspirational cards, the daily inspirational cards, the forum that cleans 24/7, you know, the gold library, etc., etc. So anyway, you still can sign up if you want, and we are going to connect in kind of in a half an hour. We start at 1 p.m. Los Angeles time. And today we are going to talk about freedom or slavery, because we are in those kind of times and those kind of moments where we really need to choose. Well, what are you going to choose? Freedom or slavery? And it's moment by moment that you are choosing that. If you engage with certain things, please, please, please don't believe the news. And if you engage with the news and if you believe them, please don't watch them anymore. Okay? There is plenty of information out there to help you to connect, to help you to trust, to help you to realize you are not alone and you have a lot of protection and a lot of guidance, if you allow it, yes? So it's always that choosing moment by moment. And tomorrow, Friday, I am doing the Ho'oponopono mini workshop with translation to Russian. So if you have any Russian friends, please let them know, because it's an opportunity. We do that tomorrow, Friday, And if you are interested, you can put some comments below, and we'll be able to send you to the right information. So it's the same mini workshop that I did in English some month ago, and that is actually in my store, and you can have access right now. But tomorrow I'm doing it with translation to Russian. And Saturday I'm actually doing an online training for the people in Madrid, because I was supposed to be in Madrid. So for people can sign up in absentee and participate in the training on Saturday, but that one will be in Spanish. And this is why I decided to connect today, that anyway I wanted to take the opportunity, to wish you a happy Thanksgiving, to say thank you for being in my life, for showing up in my life. But also I knew that I couldn't connect on Saturday, and I have not been connecting as much lately because I was traveling and I was doing trainings. But since I have a training also this Saturday, I decided to connect today with you, and so that you know that I'm here for you. Okay, and you know what? Soon I'm gonna start replying to your comments or your questions here on the social media. So be sure to leave me your questions here too, and maybe you are lucky enough that I will answer you in a video that we will publish. Okay, so we will start doing that soon. And again, I wish you a very happy Thanksgiving and a very happy life, new life that is ahead of us. I hope you really choose love and no fear. Okay? And that you are courageous enough to go through whatever we have to go through, because we know what is ahead of us. That is much brighter, much better. Okay? It is that we always dream of, and we thought, oh, not possible. Now it is possible. But are you willing to let go of your past? Are you willing to forgive? Are you willing to stay present and allow the help to come? Okay? Remember, you have free choice. So we are going to close with a piece of I that says, peace be with you, all my peace, the peace that is I, the peace that is I am, the peace for always, now, and forever and evermore. My peace I give to you, my peace I leave with you. Not the world's peace, but only my peace, the peace of I. God bless you guys. Love you. Again, thank you so much for showing up in my life, for giving me the opportunities to clean. Love you. Bye.